Genesis chapter 1 verse 31, and God saw everything that he has made, and behold, it was very good. God revealed his work. And if you study Genesis chapter 1, you will see, they say he created day 1, he created day 2, he created day 3, he created morning and night, and he rested. There were 7 days in a week, and the Bible says that on the 7th day he rested. Yet God worked from day 1 to day 6. God is not a lazy man. God is not a lazy man. Out of 7 days in a week, God worked on day 1, day 2. Let's assume those days were Monday. He worked on Monday, he worked on Tuesday, he worked on Wednesday, he worked on Thursday, he worked on Friday, he worked on Saturday. He rested on Sunday. So if God is not lazy, why are you lazy? Why are you idle? And that is why poverty is overcoming some of us, because we are idle. And we hide under Christianity to cover our idleness. You think prayer alone cannot bring you money. There is nothing you are needing your hands on. And you are using prayer and fasting, night vigil alone, dry fasting, 3 days fasting, to hide your idleness. Praying on the mountain, but you are not doing anything, you are lazy. And when you get a job, you can't hold the job because you are not hardworking, you are not diligent. God is not a lazy man. He worked for 6 days, rested on the 7th day. Morning and night, morning and night. He had a duty, he had an assignment. He wanted to recreate the world. He worked day 1, day 2, day 3. Most of us are lazy in the house, we are lazy in the office, we are lazy on the road. And that is why we are not prospering. God was a hard worker. And because we are created in the image of God, I rebuke every spirit of laziness, every spirit of procrastination, every spirit of idleness in your life. I bind it and I cast it out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lay your hands on something. Nothing happens unless you push. And before you can get a reaction, there must be an action on your part. That is one of the laws of one of the scientists, I think Nathan. There must be, every action must bring a reaction. But before you can get a reaction, in times of open doors, opportunities, you must push. Nothing happens unless you take steps. Do something today. Your father, God, is not a lazy man, but we are so lazy. You work in the office, you don't want to work, but you want to receive a pay. Even domestic work, most of the new generation don't want to work. I rebuke every spirit of idleness, procrastination, and laziness. Receive the spirit of hard work, and God shall give you profits for your hard work. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.